it's genius.
Yeah, it really creates that symmetry in the space and a focal point, which is so important in the kitchen.
It is a story of warmth. It's just a space you want to live in. Welcome to Making Home, where we take one family's house and turn it into a beautiful family home.
And this week it's all about the kitchen and butler's pantry.
So the kitchen really is at the heart of the home, literally and physically. It runs straight out to the alfresco area at the rear of the home. It sits adjacent to the dining room, and it's also beautifully close to the living room. It is really nice when you are in the middle of the home. The kids can come down and sit at the bench. Anybody who's watching the news can also be with you. It's all about having everybody together.
And that island bench is just ginormous. So there'll be lots of fun out there. There were three things we needed to deliver for the kitchen. Firstly, it needed to be a showstopper aesthetically. This is delivered through the beautiful cabinetry, stunning accents.
The second thing we really needed this kitchen and butler's pantry area to deliver was functionality. It had to not only look good, but it needed to work really hard.
And the third thing that we love to include is a few little clever ideas and moments that really make the space.
One of the biggest components when you are planning your kitchen is always going to be the cabinetry. And you want every single drawer, every cupboard to really deliver. So what we did was we went into Bunnings and we actually spent quite a bit of time with the team in there, and they are amazing. They took us through the samples, they took us through all of the accessories. We were able to actually have a play. And then what you can do, which we did, was we brought a whole lot of colour samples back to the house so that we could see how that worked in the space and in the light, different times of the day, and also with all of our other materials. We ended up opting for Licorice Twist, which is a beautiful deep black. Now it's not a flat finish, it's a beautiful timber grain finish. And that runs through and it creates that lovely texture which we always like to see in all of our materials. So the quality of this cabinetry is actually incredible, it really is. Even the drawers, they've got these beautiful metal-sided drawers, the beautiful soft close mechanisms. Everything just feels like beautiful quality. The great thing about the Caboodle range too is that they've got a whole lot of really standard cabinetry. Some of the stuff you can get straight off the shelf, some you need to order. But the other thing is, if you are a clever DIYer or you're working with your builder as to install, is you can order some of their panels and then you can start to cut down to create some of your own clever little moments. So we did that in the butler's pantry. We used their American oak bench tops to create some beautiful shelving. And then above that microwave, we've actually created a beautiful platter stacker using some of their preformed panels. Then we teamed that up with these beautiful copper handles, which we got from Hardware in General. It is a story of warmth. It's just a space you want to live in.
I absolutely love the flooring in the kitchen. It's really soft underfoot, but it's also perfect for high traffic areas because it's really durable. And what we chose was the Chevron Nordic Icicle flooring from Beaumont Tiles. With a big family, what I love about the floors is any spills won't soak in and it's super easy to clean up.
And that is just working so beautifully with that cabinetry, with that copper detailing that we've got in there. It literally is such perfect harmony.
So we've got big glass doors off the kitchen and we decided to use gorgeous linen shears to close them up. They're great for insulation, but also for privacy. Another great thing about the shears is that they flow off from the living room, giving that continuity throughout the spaces.
Honestly, Kevin from Art of Marble was incredible. You know, I told him what we were looking for and, you know, the fact that we wanted something that was natural, that was safe, but that was going to perform really well. He suggested that we use their beautiful Carrara marble. We've got that on the bench tops, we've got that on the splashbacks. I can't stop touching it.
No, it's a real showstopper and it takes it to the next level. It's just beautiful.
I think the thing about renovating is that you've always got to be prepared to make little changes along the way. And we certainly had to make a few of those, didn't we?
We did.
One of the things we had to change and do a little bit of a pivot on was the amount of stone that we were going to include in the build. Cost, of course, was a big factor. So instead of using stone above the range hood, we introduced James Hardie Axon cladding, which is exactly the same as we've used above the fireplace. We've used that in the study, so we've got that really nice thread running through the home. And then we love the look of that so much with that little copper detail on it that we've put that on the front face of the island bench as well.
So when it came to choosing the appliances, we knew they had to stack up for performance and looks.
We really wanted to find as many appliances as possible that would integrate completely for that really seamless look. So if it's possible, Liz is just a little bit obsessed with this clean-made 90 centimetre oven.
It's true, I absolutely love it, and I have to show you this feature.
Look at this, it just slides out on the wheels, meaning your tray won't drop when you're getting heavy things out of the oven. It's amazing.
And how good is it to have that big, wide 90 centimetre oven? You could have two roasts, you could have sheets of cookies, you could feed a family so well with this oven.
And how beautiful is this induction cooktop? It's got 6 cooking zones, means it's perfect for this big house and a big family. And it looks beautiful and sleek in this kitchen as well.
There's a function, if you wanted to boil water, you just dial it right up to P for power, and the water boils in seconds.
Oh my God, I love that. When the kids are screaming and they want dinner done in a second, you can just get that pasta out.
And of course, every good cooktop needs an amazing range hood. This one's perfect, concealed so you can't see it at all. Then when you need it, it just pops out, nice and powerful, does the job.
And we've also got another 2 ovens back here, which is great for when you're entertaining or if you just need to cook something small and not having to heat up a big oven. So we've got a standard oven here, and then up here we've got a steam, convection oven and microwave.
The touch on, touch off technology in this tap is amazing. I love it. If you've got really messy hands, you just walk over. You don't need to touch the tap at all. You literally just do that and it comes on.
I love that.
Wash your hands, touch off, walk away. This tap is all about the features because not only has it got that touch on, touch off technology, but it's got this fabulous spray, which is perfect for veggies, also perfect for washing out a big sink like this.
I wasn't sure about this sink when you chose it, Nikki, because I like a divide in my sink so I can rinse and wash. But you seem to have me convinced now, I think.
Well, I've always loved being able to take a big platter or an oven tray or a baking tray and dump it straight into a sink, which you can't do with a divided sink.
That's true.
So in the butler's pantry, we wanted to mirror the tapware that we had out in the main kitchen. So we've gone for the same, the Galliano from Greens, but this is the slimline version. It doesn't have the touch on, touch off technology, but it does have a lovely option whereby you can just twist the end of the tap and you can get a stream or a spray. We wanted to do a little switch out, so we've gone for the black sink here. This is the Alessi sink. It's the smaller bowl. I've gone single again for better functionality. Again, tough, hardy, chip resistant, stain resistant. It's that Granitec product, which is obviously super tough. But I love the way the black sink is actually offsetting the tiles and the bench top. So when it came to the butler's pantry, we thought this would be a nice opportunity to try and save a little bit of money. So instead of the marble bench tops, we've actually gone for the Caboodle American Oak bench tops, which we've lime washed with a polyurethane lime wash. That's going to make that extra durable. And then when it came to the splashbacks, instead of using the marble, we actually had a whole lot of marble herringbone tiles from Beaumont's that were left over from the bathroom floors. So we cut them off the sheets and then we've laid them as vertical subways, which actually ties in beautifully with the bathrooms. So one thing we always encourage everybody to do when they're planning their kitchen is to walk the kitchen, just as though you were living a normal day. So what we did when we were planning where we wanted to put the dishwasher is we said we'll be at the dining room table, we'll come in here with our dishes, we'll head over here, we can put the dishes here, we can put any rubbish straight into the bin if they need to have a little rinse through the sink, and then into our beautifully integrated dishwasher. A really nice flow, beautifully integrated. All of your controls are sitting on the top here. And then when it's closed, you wouldn't even know it was there. There's actually a little light that shows up on the floor. So nobody's going to come walking into the kitchen and open the door and have water flying everywhere. And you know what, Liz, you were genius. When we were planning the fridges, the automatic reaction of mine was to put them side by side, just like a normal double fridge. But you came up with the idea of actually separating them and creating that beautiful focal point in the kitchen.
This is one of the three fridges in this house, but it is a beauty.
It is amazing, isn't it? You look at that cabinetry and you would never know that there was a fridge in there.
I know.
But the nice thing about them is that they're not too big. Yeah. They can sit together if you wanted the idea of a double fridge, or they can be separate. And what we've been able to do here is one fridge is for fruit and veg, another one is for meat and dairy, and then the one that's in the butler's pantry is the drinks fridge.
And come here, let me show you my secret stash spot. How cool is that?
Margaritas, is it too early?
And who says fridges need to sit side by side?
It's genius.
Yeah, it really creates that symmetry in the space and a focal point, which is so important in the kitchen.
It's come together magically. Two things to show you here. The first one is this stunning Oregon butcher's block. Now, when we were building the house, we had a beam that went right across the back of the house on the outside. We had to cut it up into sections, but what I did was I actually took them out to Jake's place. He has a company called Timber 2 out in Mudgee. So I took them out there and then he has put it together. He's actually joined two pieces together to create this stunning butcher's block. Just feel that. He's machined it all back. He's done such a beautiful job, and that is solid timber.
It's beautiful, and it's so nice to incorporate part of the old home into the new.
But look at this, I've got a surprise. If you are the kind of person who likes to do a little bit of teppanyaki while you've got friends here, or even if you wanted to have the kids cooking with you, oh, I have put in here a 60 centimetre induction cooktop.
I did not see that coming.
I know. So we wanted to create a show-stopping kitchen. It needed to be aesthetically gorgeous, but we also wanted it to work really hard. I think we have absolutely nailed it. What do you think, Liz?
I am never wanting to leave this kitchen. It is just beautiful.
Let's go and cook.
I'm going to get the margaritas.